Hello everybody, this is Yash Pandit and today I'm going to discuss all about RRBJ and how you should prepare for that, how you have to fill your form and what will be the basic thing which you have to keep in your mind to get selection in this particular exam. A very big opportunity for different engineers because this is, you can say that, one of the great department which is present in India, and the department is hiring around 14,000 recruitment is there. So you can say that this is a very big opportunity for you. So you should prepare yourself well for this particular exam. Let's understand the basis of this exam, how to prepare, what to prepare, how to fill the form. Because in this particular exam, what is important is which zone you are selecting for the exam. Because there are some zones which are having very high cutoff. There are some zones which are having very low cutoff. So it's safe to handle the exam with that particular area in which there are less chances of getting higher cutoff, or you can say that there is more chances of low cutoff or lower cutoff region. So I will give you the basic details which particular region you have to select for this exam and how you have to prepare. Fine. So let's start with the basic thing, that is what will be the process of application. The application can be, it's online application. The form is starting from 2nd of January and the ending date is 31st of January. You have to keep these things in your mind and try to fill the form as early as possible, because this time the exam is online, so it's better to get a great center, to get a good center. So you have to just apply as soon as possible. Fine, don't wait for the last date. So this is 2nd of January, keep this in your mind, and then you have to apply for this particular exam. Now what will be the payment closing date? You can say that for offline payment, the closing date is 4th of February. For online payment, the closing date is 5th of February. So this will be the ending. And finally, 7th Feb is the final date when everything will be closed for this particular examination. So fine, so you can see this. These are the details. These are the dates, because sometimes what happens is that the student forget the dates, and because of that, some confusion is there. So they forget. So chhoot jata. Ye recruitment ka jo advertisement hai, chance hai, you should not let it go, because it is a very great opportunity. I'm telling you. 14,000 seats are more than enough and you can get easily into this department. So let's, first of all, let's understand which zone you have to select for the examination, because this is one of the most important thing to clear the examination. There are various zones for which seats are there. You can see this. This is Ahmedabad. The seats are 399, Ajmer 825, Allahabad 1446, bahut sare seats hain. Bangalore 708, Bhopal 383, Bhubaneswar 242, Bilaspur this is 404, Chandigarh 996, Chennai again bahut sari seats hain, Gorakhpur 645, Bilaspur 404, repeat ho gaya, it's fine. Chandigarh again, this is Chennai, this is Gorakhpur. In Gorakhpur this is 645 seats. These are also, you can say that, achhi seats hain wahan pe. Thiruvananthapuram 137, Guwahati 586, Srinagar 460, Kolkata this much bahut achhi seats hain. Malda again 248 and Mumbai 1544. So these are the, you can say that, bifurcation of seats for different zones. Now how you have to select the zones? Dekho, there are certain zones in which there are less number of students who are preparing for the examination, who have idea of this examination. See, there are certain regions, like for example, if you consider North India, if you consider North India, this detail I am giving you as per the previous RRB recruitment, because pehle kya hota tha, RRB mein hamesha se zone you have to select and you have to give the exam on the same day for different zones. So ye pehle se hi RRB ka system aise hi chalta hai, pehle SSC mein bhi aise hi chalta tha, JE mein bhi aise hi chalta tha. To uske analysis ke base pe ye cheez I am telling you. North India mein what is the case, there are many students who are taking coaching here. There are many students, large gathering is there, there are many students. Also the population is large, population bahut zyada hai. There are great number of students who are preparing for the different examination, and the population also there. Also the interest for government examination is much greater in Northern India, because there are many students who from their childhood they have a basic dream to get into a government service. So unka money aisa hota hai ki mujhe government service pe jana hai, from the very, you can say that, from the childhood. So yahan pe kya hota hai, North India mein बहुत ज्यादा क्रेज है गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज का. दैट्स व्हाई यू कैन से दैट देयर स्टूडेंट्स आर मोर अवेयर अबाउट गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स, और रदर यू कैन से दैट देयर आर मोर इंटरेस्टेड. बट दिस इज नॉट इन द केस ऑफ साउथ इंडिया. इन साउथ इंडिया द स्टूडेंट्स आर जनरली interested. Students are there and they are interested, but generally they are not that much having interest as compared to that of the North Indian students. Also, the population is less, the gathering is less. That's why it is very suitable to fill the form those areas which are present in South India, because railway is basically a central department. Railway is a central department, and in central department, the transfers can be from one place to another place all across the country. Fine. So the most important thing is to get entry into this particular department. After that, you can change your place. Fine. This is not a very big deal. You can easily get transferred from different places. So why I'm telling you this? Because it is very important to select the zone properly. Now, if you'll see that ki yaar Allahabad mein it is around 1400, 1500 seats are there. So let's fill the form from Allahabad. No, it's not like that. Because if you are filling the form from Allahabad, then in that case, the population, the students, the number of students who are filling the form for Allahabad, they are also in the ratio of these number of seats only. Lakhs of students will be filling the form from Allahabad, because Allahabad in UP is an education hub. It is an education hub. Ek area aisa, bachche bahut hote hain wahan. To wahan pe fir aapko kya hoga? Risk ho jayega, because there are large number of students who will be there. Fine. The similar case is if you consider Chandigarh. So Chandigarh ke saath bhi the case is same, because Chandigarh is very nearby to Delhi. If you are filling the form saying ki ye 1000 seats are there, so it is also very difficult for you to get into this particular department through this area. Samajh mein aa raha hai? You have to select that region in which you are safe. Similar case is Kolkata. If you select Kolkata, the Kolkata is basically capturing different regions. In Kolkata, the population density is very high. There are large number of students which are present there. The colleges are also in great number. You have to just take care of that. Fine. Now, what are the places where I can fill the form? What are the basic priorities where I should fill the form? So, I'll tell you the priorities. I'll tell you my priorities and you can select as per that case. Ye nahi dal raha hai ki yaar is tarike mein is jagah nahi jana. India is India. India is our country. You can go anywhere. Fine. It is not like any issue. Let's take different priorities for different reasons. So, first of all, let's take the first priority. First priority, what I'll go with is, let's see this. I have a place here which is Chennai. The Chennai is here, and in Chennai the seats are 1100 seats are there now. 1200 you can say that, 1183 is there. So what will be my first preference is that you should fill the form from Chennai. You can fill the form from Chennai, because Chennai means the seats are also in large number and the number of students who will be giving the exam are also less. So just give it first priority. This is our first priority. And after Chennai, what we can do is that we can select another region of such place where the population will be less and we can have better chances to get into the services. So, uske liye what I'll suggest is ki aap fir se, jaise maine pehle aapko bataya, ab Bangalore hai, to Bangalore is this having a 700 number of seats, around 708 number of seats. So, again, I'll give the second priority to Bangalore. I'll give the second priority to Bangalore, because Bangalore is a place which is having students are there, but generally the students who are present there, they are doing jobs and all those things. They are having a busy life, but they are having a busy life. So what it means, because they cannot easily prepare for the examination, because to prepare for the government examination, you have to save your time. You have to give time for the preparation. It is not in the case of the students who are present in Bangalore. So what will be my second priority is you should give Bangalore the second priority. You can fill the form or seats bhi achhi khasi. You can select the seats also. Fine. Now, what will be the another region which we can target or which we can select? Thiruvananthapuram is also there, but 137 seats bahut kam hoti hain, so we will not go with that. Instead of that, what we can select is we can select Guwahati. We can select Guwahati. So our third priority will be Guwahati. Why I am going for Guwahati? Because one student was there, I guess around when the 2011 notification paper was there for senior section junior, the student was from Delhi only. He filled the form from Guwahati and he gets selected easily. Because Guwahati ke andar the same cases there, the population is very less. Population bahut kam hai. To wo IIT Guwahati ya do teen engineering colleges are there, unhi ke bachche generally fill karte hain. But problem fir wo ye pass positive cheez kya ho jati hai ki final year students are strictly not eligible. Final year students are strictly not eligible for this particular examination. It is clearly mentioned in the notification. So, ye pass outs ke liye, this is a positive side, because if final year cannot affect, college students cannot
appear. And Guwahati is such an area where generally engineering colleges, which are like IIT Guwahati is there, so students finally can apply kar nahi sakte. And the students who have completed their BTech, they'll come back to their place or for the coaching in different areas like Delhi or wherever it is. It means that the Guwahati is also a safe place. So these are the three priorities which I am giving you. You can select out of these three. Iske alawa, if you want, so I can tell you that you can select with the same criteria. Ki their population should be less. The number of population of engineering students, let's consider that, should be less. Or the interest and the awareness should be less. If you'll go with Allahabad, I'm telling you, it's very difficult to compete because every student is aware there. They have only one dream in Allahabad, get into the government services. Similarly, the case with Bhopal. Bhopal mein case is same. Ajmer is also the case is same. Chandigarh is also case is same. Gorakhpur. All these areas are very, like, you can say that the competition will be very high in these areas. So you have to prepare yourself accordingly. That's why these are the safest areas. Koi dikkat nahi hai. Chennai is a very good place. Bangalore is a nice place, beautiful place. And Guwahati is also, you can say that, a very beautiful place. You can prepare yourself well and you can give the exam from these areas. It's not a big problem there. Koi dikkat nahi hai. Fine. So zone ka, I think I have cleared the concept how to just select the zone. Now let's come to the exam preparation. As you all must be knowing, I have launched an online program for RRBJ where I'll be providing you all the classes from stage 1 to stage 2 till the document verification, medicals, all these things. We'll be cleaning, we'll be dealing and discussing. Fine. So in that online course, we'll be providing you each and every lecture which you can watch any number of times whenever you want. The content will also be clear. The regular test series is also there. The study material is also there. So you can easily clear the examination. That's why we are saying that if you will follow us properly, if you will follow each and every step whichever we are giving you, if you will do that, then definitely you will be clearing the examination. There is no chance that you will not clear the examination. Fine. So let's come to the stages of the examination. In this examination, the notification is saying that there are two different stages, and after that document verification and medical is there. Fine. So medical ke liye, I'll upload a separate video because medical is also a very important criteria in railway because it is generally a very, you can say that, a great confusion between the students ki medical mein kya hota hai and all these things. So for that, we'll upload a different video. So se aapko clarity mil jayegi. So let's start with the stage 1. Stage 1, which is commonly known as CBT 1. Aajkal bada famous ho raha hai CBT pattern. So it is known as CBT 1. Now CBT 1 is what? It is computer-based test hai iske andar. Stage 1 mein, they are basically giving you 100 questions per question 1 marks and the time is 90 minutes. 100 questions, 90 minutes. Very small, direct type of questions will be there. 100 marks will be there. The stage 1 consists of 4 different things. Basic maths. Basic maths matlab basic ideas. Bot maths ho gaya, aapka multiplication, division, geometry ho gaya, all these things. 30 marks weightage is given to this. So we'll be dealing with that in our classes. And we'll giving you a great practice. Sab aapne padha hua hai, you just need practice and basic revision. So wo classes aapka ekdam doubt ekdam clear kar denge, sab samajh mein aa jayega. Reasoning is also there. General reasoning is also there. It is having 25 marks weightage. General awareness, GK is also there. Achhi, isko weightage dena hai hame. 15 marks secure karna difficult ho jata hai. General awareness is a very broad, you can say that, subject because current affairs is also included in this. Now next is science. In science, you have to study physics, you have to study chemistry, you have to study life science. So these three will be covering and it is having a heavy weightage, that is 30 marks. So basically, first priority, second priority, these are our priorities. You have to deal with that accordingly. Fine. Next. Stage 1, as I told you, is having 90 minutes time period, 100 marks, 100 questions will be there. It is just a qualifying examination, which means that you have to just qualify it. Now, railway has suggested in their notification, the railway board has suggested that for unreserved general category, the minimum qualifying marks is 40%. For OBC, 30%, SC, 30%, ST, 25%. These are the marks which are provided by railway board. Fine. So they have just fixed a minimum percentage which you have to secure for the CBT 1. You have to clear. Now, if you are just preparing yourself properly, you can easily clear the CBT 1. If you are having a proper guidance and proper path, you can clear that examination. But as I told you, you cannot take this lightly because these kind of opportunity comes once in 4 or 5, 6 years. That's the case. You cannot lose this opportunity. Leave this opportunity. Now, let's come to stage 2, CBT 2. Now, For CBT 1, they have suggested that the exam will be in April or May. So what we are thinking that the exam is in April, so we'll complete the syllabus as per that, so that you can have a better and basic concept developing also, and you can have a great practice also. We also, what we'll do is that we will start preparing you for CBT 2 also with CBT 1, because we know that CBT 1 you can easily clear if you follow the classes. That's why we'll start with CBT 2, because you can say that they have not provided us with the basic timing or basic, you can say that date for CBT 2, but what we are expecting that the CBT 2 will be in this year only, because the seats are in large in number and they require the junior engineers in the department. Fine. Stage second CBT is having 150 questions. 150 questions will be there, and the time period will be 120 minutes. Again, objective type questions will be there. Questions will be objective, multiple type, objective type questions will be there. And it is having, as I told you, 150 questions, 150 marks, 120 minutes. Four non-tech portions, general ability again, science, physics, chemistry, computer, basic computer, environment and pollution. 10 marks, 10 marks, 15 marks, 15 marks. Fine, this is the non-technical part. Now, plus the technical ability, the best thing which Railway did this year is that agar aap civil ke ho, you have to give civil. If you are mechanical, you have to give mechanical. If you are computer science, you have to give computer science. This is the best thing which Railway did this year, because every time the notification comes, the student find it very difficult what to study, what not to study, and the same case happened with them in the period of examination. Wo samajh mein nahi aata hai, upar likha hota hai, civil engineering, pehla question hota hai, what is an array? What will be the type of array? So, samajh mein nahi aata. Array is in computers. So, why they are asking us in civil? Well, these kind of confusions always comes in the mind of students. So, that's why Railway just rooted out this confusion and say that your technical ability will be branch specific. That is, if you are civil, you'll give the examination from civil, mechanical from mechanical. So, the total will be 150 marks. You have to prepare yourself well, because many students are preparing. There are some students who are in job, who are already as working as a junior engineer in some department. They are also preparing for the examination, because in a little way, the junior engineer will be getting a salary of around, I'm telling you, after 7th pay commission, the JE salary will be around, you can say that 58,000 will be the in-hand salary. In-hand salary means after PF and all those reduction, the total salary will be around 65,000. After deduction, you will get in-hand salary of around 58,000. This is a nice remuneration. You can prepare yourself for this examination. Also, after getting into the JEE post of junior engineer, you can again prepare for Indian Engineering Services examination. You can prepare for that also. Fine. So, for that only, we have just launched this online course. You can join this course. And if you want to take admission, what you can do is that just log in. Just visit the website. Our website is www.thecatalystgroup.info. Group, which we are now presently, we can proudly say that we are the biggest engineers group in our country, where we have presently 3.5 lakhs of students who are together studying on our portal .info. You can go to this link, and first of all, what you have to do is that you have to, there's an option of sign up. You can sign up onto the website. While doing sign up, you will create your login ID and personal password, and using those credentials you will log in again, you will sign in, and then you will go to, there is an option of full course. You can go to the option of full course. There you will find two courses for RRB full course and RRB non-tech course for all the branches. Full courses we have for civil and mechanical only. Non-tech is CBT 1 non-tech plus CBT 2 non-tech, everything. You can directly click on those course. The course will give you two options, pay half or pay full. Half is just an installment. You can pay in installments in a period of 1 month. There is no extra charge directly from the website. So, this is AS Pandit. I hope that I have cleared many concepts and doubts regarding this examination. This is AS Pandit signing off this introductory session. Take care. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Thank you.